crazy Canadians.
We're doing a bit of a Swiss Alp climb. We're on probably a 2 foot wide walking ledge here. Go down there, down to the glaciers. And there's Rob. I'm trying to make some echoes, of course.
Yeah, I want to go home.
And up in here is the big glaciers.
Yo, lady.
And a few moments ago, we just missed.
Bang, bang.
Well, we saw it.
Boom, boom.
A bit of an avalanche, and you can sort of see on the side there where the leftover snow is, and just kind of dumped to the bottom. And we're gonna hike up to the edge here. There's a water reservoir. There's a waterfall. Beautiful waterfall, I'm sure. It's quite windy up here. But beautiful, well worth it. Want to say a few words, Rob? Oh.
We're almost at the top of Lake Louise. Mountain up here. And we're soon to do yoga moves next.
Oh, God. I love yoga, but doing Rob yoga is kind of odd.
And it has begun.
This is Rob yoga.
Real easy one.
This is all he does.
Kids, don't try this at home.
Apparently this is his flying butterfly or dragon or something. I don't know.
That was a yoga move.
A grasshopper. That's Rob yoga.
Episode one.
Lord. Oh, so nice. Now this is the wilderness of Canada, the real wilderness, at least one of them. So many beautiful, great places to come visit here, so if you're not from Canada, you must come. I am from Canada, not in this area, but West Coast, BC. Glorious there as well, so if you ever make it over there, you have to definitely make it to the island. All along the coast is gorgeous. Of course, I'm being biased. If you come, you can make up your own opinion. Yet again, like Louise.
It's amazing.
Oh, look at these kids. Oh, they're so cute. Got some toques on. Poor guy's a little cold. Wow, they did quite the hike. These kids are probably like 4 years old. That's what I want to do eventually, if I ever have. Okay, let's not go there. Okay, I'm gonna go now, and we'll come back again soon.
Rock art marker. Time to continue on our path. Let's follow the next.
Sorry, no worries.
I will buy my content.
vine maple and a babbling brook. Not quite a beaver dam.
Adventure starts. This time around, going to Pemberton. Well, actually, beyond Pemberton, to a little river called the Lillooet River. Pretty good day. Beautiful that way. We're bumping.
This way out to the west, looking like a little bit of a windy day.
Over here, Gross Mountain straight ahead. And heading north. Oh yeah. Gonna be a good time. Good adventure.
Thank you.
We are pretty much at the top. We are at the top. I went a little bit further than the actual top. And this is the glaciers. So this is called the Plain of Six Glaciers. So at one time there was more, obviously. And so there's this canyon here. And it goes into that canyon over there. And then goes down the valley. And then the far distance, probably about 8 kilometers away, is Lake Louise. This hike is about 3 hours in total, so it takes about an hour and a half to get up. It took us a little bit longer because we stopped and took pictures. You know, the typical thing. No worries. And above the glaciers is beautiful waterfall. So there's a few waterfalls in this area that feed down into the river that eventually goes down into Lake Louise. So there's a few, and obviously the glacier is feeds into it as well. This is the waterfalls, obviously. And it's quite windy up here, as you can tell. Very windy. Well, people are kind of stopping here and chatting away. Rob's down there, people, and of course myself as a mountain goat, I have to head up just a little bit further. So I'm gonna let go for now and head up to the waterfall. Maybe we'll be back in a minute.
I wish I had a button where I could push it and they'd all play.
Like a dandelion.
It's insane.
Like the white puff.
This is Sphere Alley. Nice.
brook. And they were lucky. It only cut off the end part of the barrier. Those Americans at that time, five of them.
Classic old Cessna. Go, little Cessna.
You can see the pad is all blown over.
Hi there, little one.
Are you
the heavy duty? Susan will think of this. What do you think Susan will think of you?
Yeah.
Show yeah.
Will you stop that?
So they changed the hair. So what they scared, this one scared them all.
She would love to have someone here in my yard.
He's checking out his deer buddies. Hi, how you doing? So they're startled by him, not us. Yeah. See you around. We gotta go, kids. Bye. Yonder Canadian hanging out in the creek. What hear thee say? Handy dandy Canadian man hanging in the lake. What ye say? Alright. Wicked. Go for the bump.
This one with the red whatever chip on it has been here like the last 3 hours. Yeah.
Wicked. Go for the bump.
second.
Tiny little thing. Probably for kids.
Interesting that they have that marker here.
It's probably, it doesn't change much at this particular point. It's a very wide river, so if it goes up a foot, it might be surprising. Hi there, little one. Are you? Are you the heavy duty?
Susan will think of this. What do you think Susan will think of you?
Yeah.
Show yeah.
Change the hair. So what they scared, this one scared them all. Him, not us. Yeah. See you around. We gotta go, kids. Bye. Yonder Canadian hanging out in the creek. What hear thee say? Handy dandy Canadian man hanging in the lake. What ye say? All right. Wicked. Go for the bump.
This one with the red whatever chip on it has been here like the last 3 hours. Yeah.
Wicked. Go for the bump.
Go over there in a second.
Tiny little thing, probably for kids.
Interesting that they have that marker here.
Probably it doesn't change much at this particular point. It's a very wide river, so if it goes up a foot, it might be surprising. Thank you.
Yonder Canadian hanging out in the creek. What hear thee say? Handy dandy Canadian man hanging in the lake. What ye say? All right. Yonder Canadian hanging out in the creek. What hear thee say? Handy dandy Canadian man hanging in the lake. What ye say? All right. Yonder Canadian hanging out in the creek. What hear thee say? Handy dandy Canadian man hanging in the lake. What ye say? All right.
Really good with that, right? So they're not the best. It looks good, you know.
This one with the red whatever chip on it has been here like the last 3 hours. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you.
Wicked. Go for the bump.
All the lighter colored stuff is just the trailing edge of all of the massive, massive debris. They said it was 48 million tons of debris that actually came down from the side of a hill behind this hill that's even bigger than that hill. Meager Creek. Hot springs back in there and nobody can get to anymore because a $1 million bridge got washed out in the process, and Meager Mountain, Mount Meager, is behind this one. And it's huge compared to this, like double or triple the size of this little guy.
Hey you.